Hi, do you have a regular thermostat or separate thermostat valves for each room in your house? Then this tutorial is for you. I'm going to show you how to have your thermostat or thermostat valves automatically controlled by Home Assistant using a schedule that takes into account whether someone is home. This way, you can control the heating in your home completely locally without needing a subscription from your provider. Some time ago, there was some controversy around Tado because they had put the control of individual radiator valves behind the paywall. They reversed that decision after user complaints, but it once again shows that you don't want to be dependent on cloud services. That's why I automated my heating using Home Assistant, and now I'm going to show you how I did that. Let's go to Home Assistant. To get my heating automation running in Home Assistant, I started by creating some helpers. So I'm going to the helpers page and I created a filter on the label climate. And what you can see here is that I created four helpers, and one of those helpers is the climate temperature away helper. This is a number helper, and that number helper contains a value 16 in this case, and that's the temperature value that my radiator valves will get when everybody leaves the house. Next to that, I created three other climate schedule helpers. So I first created the main climate schedule helper, which is a schedule helper. And in the schedule helper, you can create, schedules. And you can create blocks of time. And for each block, you can add some parameters. So first I have a block on Sunday from 12 to 8 a.m. And what you can see is in the additional data, I am setting a variable temp with the value 15. So then I've got a block on Sunday from 8 a.m. to 12 a.m., so basically till midnight. And then I set the temp to 19 degrees. Okay. So for other days, on Mondays, I also have a schedule. And you can see that between 8 and 6 p.m. I set the temperature to 18 degrees. And in the evening, I set the temperature from 6 p.m. to midnight to 19 degrees. And so on, and so on. So this is what you can use the schedule helper for. Okay. I created some other schedule helpers. For instance, the bathroom climate schedule, just to show you. As you can see, during the week, I have a block between 12 a.m. and 7 a.m., which is the temperature is 15 degrees. And then in the morning, between 7 a.m. and 8:30, the temperature is set to 19 degrees. During the day, the temperature is set to 15 degrees. In the evening, just before I go to bed somewhere, I set the temperature to 19 degrees. And then after 10 p.m., I set the temperature back to 15 degrees. So you can create various schedules for instance, in this case, it's for a separate room, the bathroom. But you can also set a temperature for, let's say, your main temperature that you want for most of your radiators in your house. Or if you have only one thermostat, then you can also use one schedule. And I have a low climate schedule, and that's basically for all my valves that I want to control manually. So those are set from 12 to 12, and they are all set to 15 degrees. Okay, so we started with creating the helpers for this. Now, next to that, we need some automations. So now we go to automations. I also have a filter here based on labels climate, so I have everything here. Let's say I have an automation set main climate temperature. So I'm opening this. And what you see here is in the when section, you see when main climate schedule changes state or any attributes. So I'm basically checking on the schedule that I just created. So that's main climate schedule. And I'm doing nothing more than that. Next to that, I'm checking if someone is home. So basically what I'm checking here is that if the state of zone home has a value above zero, because when the value is above zero, then someone is at home. And then we get the then do section. And in the then do section, I'm targeting all my radiator valves that I want to respond on the main climate schedule. So in this case, living room wireless sensor, living room convector left, living room convector right, living room window back, window front, etc. Scullery, toilet. And I'm going to say the target temperature should be the value of temp within my helper that I created. So within my schedule.main climate schedule, I created that variable temp. So I'm getting the attribute from my helper schedule.main climate schedule. The attribute is called temp. I'm going to convert it to a float. And what this does is that it will return the specific temperature for the time that it currently is. So let's say it is 4 a.m. in the morning, it will return 15. Let's say it's 2 p.m. in the afternoon, it will return 18. Okay? So that's basically everything you have to do to make the schedule work. Now let's go to another automation. Let's for instance say, let's take the bathroom climate temperature automation. Again, I am checking on the helper bathroom climate schedule in this case. I'm checking if someone is at home and I'm setting the target temperature to bathroom, but this time I'm checking the schedule bathroom climate schedule and the variable temp within that helper. Now there's one other automation that we want to have, and that is when everybody leaves home that you want to turn down all your radiator valves. So I created this automation, switch climate on presence. And first I'm checking if someone is home. So I created this trigger with trigger ID home, and I'm checking on zone.home if the lower limit is above zero. So if the value is above zero, it means that someone is at home. The trigger ID is home, so I can check on that trigger ID later. Then I got another one, that is this one, when home changes to zero. So this is a state trigger. I call it away, the trigger ID is away. And I'm checking again on zone home. And I'm checking if the value is becoming zero. So if the value of zone home is becoming zero, then nobody is at home. So that has trigger ID away. Then we go to the then do section. I created an if then building block, and within the if, I am checking if the home trigger ID has been triggered, or if the home trigger has been triggered. And if that is the case, then I'm setting all the radiator valves that I want to respond to the main schedule to the value of temp within the helper schedule.main climate schedule. So basically, if someone comes home, all my radiator valves will follow the schedule that I've set for them. Okay? And else, if everybody left the home, then we are going to perform an action. And in this case, the action is set the temperature set point. I did a little trick here. So I'm going to go to the YAML version so I can explain what's happening here. I'm targeting all the entity IDs. So I'm saying target entity ID is all. You can also just select every entity ID, you know, manually. But in this case, I'm targeting all in one go. And I'm going to say the temperature is going to be states input number climate temperature away, and I'm going to set it to float. So it is taking the value of the helper input number climate temperature away that I showed you before, which has the value 16. So now you might be asking why 16 and not 15. That is because entity ID is all, and that takes into account also all my air conditioners, and my air conditioners have a minimum temperature of 16. So that is why this is set to 16, this input number, climate temperature away. Okay, well, and that's it. The heating in your house is now automated by Home Assistant, and you're no longer dependent on cloud services. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos and you want to support me like these people did, go to Patreon, Ko-fi, or become a paid member of this channel. You really help me with that, and you make it possible for me to create more of these tutorials for you. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and give a comment. I really like that. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye bye.